Okay, Mr. Chairman, thank you for the introduction. Dear ladies and gentlemen, it's a real pleasure to greet you on the behalf of the Serbian Structure, Integrity and Life Society and to strengthen our friendship with the Italiano Gruppo di Cultura. So this is why I'm here primarily. To some extent, I also should present the paper. It is just a fraction of relatively detailed analysis based on testing program, including everything we usually do, like tensile testing, impact testing on instrumented sharpening pendulum, and fatigue testing, and all of it in details in respect to the welded joint. So all important regions, including parent metal, weld metal, and heat affected zone, were tested in different ways so that we get a very precise answer to the question how the welded joint is behaving in reality. And so, say reality. This is because we have actually analyzed the problem from the practical world. So there was a pressure vessel which functioned as a reactor in a plant. It was about 40 years of exploitation, and there were considerable damages on the reactor mantle. You can see the basic data here. It was low alloyed chromium molybdenum steel, designed for high temperature. That's another parameter important here. So time and temperature, time of exploitation and temperature, which was 537 centigrades. From the material point of view, just to mention that in such condition, steel tend to decarbonize. But we are not focused today on material behavior in that sense, on the logical sense of it, that is covered in other papers related to this one. So the testing that we are talking today about is tensile properties of new parent metal, new weld metal, and the whole butt welded joint. This whole butt welded joint was a bit interesting because we actually used two thick plates, 102 millimeters, one from the new material, the other from the exploited, operated for 40 years already material, and welded them together. So we had in one welded joint both new and old material, exploited material. The other, even more important for us, testing here was about fracture mechanics parameters. In this case, it was K1C, which was tested via J1C. Actually, we determined JR curves and then J1C and critical value, and then critical value of fracture intensity, stress intensity factor. As already mentioned, this is the material and then the welding, which was done in a specifically designed procedure, but more or less classical one. Root pass was by simple procedure. It's arc welding by covered electrodes. I just cannot remember what name can I use as a shortened form. And then the filling was by arc welding, submerged arc welding of filler passes, and you can see all data necessary. It was U-shaped weld, and as I told you, two different materials were joined in that way. Here are some basic data about chemical composition and mechanical properties, as given by a producer, of course, not a tested one. and this is the same for the pillar material. So what we obtained for tensile testing are standard curves, as you can see them, but please pay attention to some important differences. This is, for example, a testing of the welded joint as a whole at 20 centigrades, and here it is 540. Now you may see, of course, that tensile strength properties like yield strength and tensile strength are significantly lower, nothing new, but also pay attention to this elongation. At first glance, it is better situation with high temperature, but homogeneous deformation is approximately 1/4 of it, whereas here homogeneous deformation is 2/3, and that is much more useful behavior in a way. With this long elongation, we can't do much. It's not of big use. So in every respect, this material behaves better at 20 centigrades. Then for the parent metal, similar situation, just different values. And that was for the new material. And then for weld metal, also for new material. Somewhat different shape should be noticed here, but basically that is the same. And of course, just compare these values, 500 for yield strength and more than 600 with the previous one, which was much lower. Scales are different. Figures look the same, but scales are different. So once we got this more or less precise insight of behavior of welded joints composed of new and old material, we turned our attention to the plane strain fracture toughness. It was once again standard testing done both on a room temperature and this working temperature. So we once again followed the effect of time and temperature. Now, of course, you all know this. In addition to this fracture toughness, plane strain fracture toughness, we already calculated critical value of the crack length, and we took into account different values for elasticity modulus, and also sigma was not the same in each case. These curves are, I guess, very well known. Just to mention, this is a parent metal, new one, at the room temperature with critical J value about 60, and then at 540, critical value about 43. Then again, in another form, in a table form, we have here values for weld metal. You may see critical J integral, new one above 70, and old one around 50, and corresponding crack, critical crack length, but calculated with stress proportional to the yield strength. So when we compare this to the critical values obtained both for new heat affected zone and old heat affected zone, we might come to the wrong conclusion that these two are better. Actually, weld metal is better, but it was not the same stress that we used to calculate critical crack length. So anyhow, what we could conclude, actually first discuss and then conclude, is that to start with, all tested specimen, tensile tested specimen, cracked, broke actually in old parent metal. So that was the weakest point. And that was of very high importance for us, because we should actually decide, our main task was to decide what to do, how to repair the mantle. And we at once got the answer, do not use the old material, it's gone. We had to replace it. Then some of discussion here I don't think I should repeat because I already mentioned. One of them that it might be important that I didn't is the last one here on the slide, because the results were quite okay in sense of the values that we obtained. So the welding technology, welding specification procedure was carefully and well selected. So this is once again a couple of statements that I already explained. And in conclusion, we can once again reinstate what I already told you. For example, this unfavorable ratio of homogeneous and non-homogeneous elongation. And the most important in this respect, that the weakest resistance to crack propagation is in heat affected zone, and the best was in weld metal, not in the parent metal. That is one also very important conclusion. So welding was actually excellent, but then again, however we do it, it's overmatching. So with overmatching, however you do it, heat affected zone will be the weakest that we can't avoid. And this is once again what I already mentioned. So I think that's the last one. Thank you very much.